Welcome to the show. And since our last episode of Aviation Now, there's been a lot going on at Adelaide and Parafield. Mark Young, the Managing Director of Adelaide and Parafield Airports, is with us now to tell us more.
Well, David, in the last 12 months, we've been very busy. On the airline front, we've seen some significant growth in capacity. In fact, in the 12 months up till December 2013, from October 2011, we'll have seen something like a 70% increase in seat capacity, international, coming into and out of Adelaide. Now, that's a significant jump. And it's also now providing South Australians with the choice that they deserve, a choice of airlines, a choice of pricing, but more importantly, a choice of destinations. We've seen significant number of new destinations open up inside Europe, and with the AirAsia X arrival at the end of October, we'll see a lot more destinations opening up inside Southeast Asia and other ports. So we've seen a significant jump in capacity, and South Australians are now getting the sort of choices that they deserve. And on the building front, we've seen in the last 12 months our landside infrastructure project open up, which you can see in the background here behind me. So that comprised the car park and the Terminal 1 Plaza area, and that was combined with a lot of new signage and wayfinding that we put into place to make the journey from car park through the plaza in and out of the terminal much easier, much better passenger facilitation than we've previously had. Coming in the plaza soon, by the end of this year, we'll see a new water feature opening up, as well as we'll have some additional retail offering down in the plaza, healthy food type offering, and some public convenience.
We've noticed the plaza's become a popular venue for local events. What sort of events have made use of the area so far?
Yes, we did use the plaza this year for a number of events, and that's our intention. The plaza is a nice big space, and we can host some really big type events in the plaza, public type style events and exhibitions. So the airport supports a lot of the arts and cultural side aspect of our life here in South Australia, such as the Brighton Sculptures by the Sea. So there are some exhibitions along those lines that we can also now start to do in this open plaza space behind us. We're also starting to see a new dynamic happening with people coming to the airport for the sake of coming to look at the aircraft, using our facilities. The plaza has certainly added to that, and with the additional attractions that we're putting in the plaza over the next few months, we expect to see that side of our engagement with the community increasing.
With everything that's happening at Parafield and Adelaide airports, it's no surprise that you've been recognised nationally. I do believe there were some awards presented recently.
Look, we're really pleased with the awards. It's nice to receive independent external confirmation that some of the things that we are doing are being highly regarded, and we have received awards for it. Just recently at the Australian Airports Association annual awards night, we picked up two awards, one for Adelaide and one for Parafield. The award for Adelaide was for the landside infrastructure project and the project team award. And the other award that we picked up was for Airport of the Year for Parafield Airport in its category. We're particularly pleased with that award because it was an award for our public consultation over during our master planning process.
Also, you were presented with an award for the environment. What was that recognition?
Last month, we were also, Adelaide and Parafield Airport were the first two airports in Australia to receive from the Airport Council International the carbon accreditation. This is a globally recognised standard, and we're very pleased that Adelaide and Parafield are the first two airports in the country to be recognised for their environmental and sustainability initiatives.
And looking at the last 12 months and how Adelaide Airport has gone ahead, what's installed for the next 12 months?
Well, in addition to the AirAsia X arrival here at the end of October and Jetstar starting up two new international services in December, we are also now getting on with some expansion here at the airport. We will, in the early part of the year next year, be starting to expand our southern apron, And we're also making some improvements to the terminal to facilitate the additional international services.
It's great to see all the positive things happening at Adelaide and Parafield airports, and we look forward to the year ahead. Thanks for talking to us, Mark.
Yes, thanks, David, and we look forward to keeping you up to date as time goes on.
That was Mark Young, the Managing Director of Adelaide and Parafield Airports. We look forward to following the progress in future episodes. Well, that's it for now. See you next time when we present more positive aviation in South Australia on Aviation Now.